you know, there's an opportunity to use a different technique. So he may be, at the moment we're standing up, so this is why we're selecting these techniques, but my position might be different. So if Justin's getting me in a headlock, for example, okay, so my front elbow is not going to work so well. My knee, it's very difficult to do my knee from here. Okay, so I need to consider something else. All right, first thing, if we get to this one, first thing I need to consider is the pressure on my neck, pressure on my throat, especially on my throat. On my neck, I can take it a little bit more, okay? Not good to stay there too long, but on my throat, it's very uncomfortable. So first thing I've got to do is get it off my throat and at worst, onto my neck. I do that by turning my face inwards, okay? Better to take it on the neck, okay, than to have the pressure against the throat. So turn your head in, okay? And I apply pressure with my hand. It may not be strong enough to make him let go, but it's just that little bit of pressure off my neck because I have my carotid artery there. So if he clamps on really strong and for too long, eventually I'm going to get weaker and eventually I'm going to maybe pass out. Okay, so I want to try and turn my head in and apply some pressure here. Now, depending on his height, I might be able to reach and go a finger in the eye or philtrum, okay? Grab an ear, grab a handful of hair, whatever I can reach and whatever I think is going to cause him the most discomfort, right? So one, finger in the eye, boom, and I'm going to, you know, and again, I don't care how tough you are. You get two fingers in your eyeball, you're not going to resist against it. You're going to go with it, okay? So remember, this is a different scenario here. This person now has me around the head. You know, this is not someone who is telling me he's not happy. This is someone who's actually grabbed me now, all right? Small person, tall person, it may be hard to reach there, okay? But let me say, where you can. So it's one, up, head in, okay, hand over, eyes, philtrum, okay, ears, hair. If they got dangling jewelry, rip it, whatever you think will cause discomfort. Or you get a thumb just behind the curve of the jaw, okay, and you press in. Okay, just press in, just here. Okay, your thumb and press in. We use the thumb because it's, you know, it's stronger, and we just press in. And again, it may or may not let him go, but it's worth a shot. Okay, from here. Now turn in one, two, and press. Right. So we're here. If we want to turn, take my side fist. You know, for some of you may say hammer fist, but side fist here. Bang, and strike in. Again, how hard? As hard as you can. Strike in to his, his decorations, what he hangs off the Christmas tree, as hard as you can, all right? Because now, from here, it's difficult. I don't get much power. But now when I turn, I take this leg around a little bit. So now I get a cleaner shot. Boom, and right in hard, right? Because again, I want to cause him discomfort. Okay. If his legs are further apart, okay, I'm just mindful because there's some kids here. I don't want to get too anatomical. Okay. if his legs are further apart, I can take my reverse knife hand and strike in an upward direction. Boom, straight up. Really depends on whether I think I've got a clean shot or not. Okay. Again, there's no 50-50. Once you commit, hit hard, okay? Because it's pardon the pun, there's no in-between, all right? Because if it doesn't work, then all the person will do is they'll clamp up like Elvis, and then you're not going to get another shot, okay? So you get one shot and you give it everything, all right? It may not let him make him let go, but it will give him something to think about, and then you can work up here, all right? So again, it may not always be just, pull my head out. If the person just pulls their head out, they didn't really have the headlock on properly, but they weren't really fitting it, you know. You may be able to get out while they're trying to get the headlock on. When person is grabbing you or trying to grab you, the best chance to get out is while they're trying to do it. Once they've got it on, it's harder, of course, okay? So if he grabs me around the head, he get a headlock. He grabs, I'm trying to get out as he's doing it. I don't let him do it first and then say, okay, now what did we practice in class? If I can avoid it if I can avoid getting to that stage, avoid it. So when you're practicing in class, and I know even some of the